Good morning, everyone, and greetings from Switzerland. Yeah, after 18,000 K in 72 days across challenging road conditions in Africa, I can honestly say that my equipment has had the ultimate product test. So today I want to share with you my bike setup and why I've chosen what and how it performed. So the biggest change from last year's Pan America is that I went with a titanium frame. I had carbon during Eurasia and Pan America, and now I went with a curved Belgian Spirit titanium frame, and it didn't make any problems at all. The big difference is it is simply more stable, which is in Africa the main criteria, but it is also much more comfortable. It is like it absorbs the shocks, and I simply can be longer on the bike. So of course carbon is a bit lighter if you want to do short mountain sprints, but for going long distances, in my opinion, titanium is simply the better choice. I have a Shimano Utiqua 2x11 group. It's the same I used on Eurasia and Pan America. I went with Shimano because it is very reliable. I never had any problems. And it is also global standard. So if I get into a problem, which can always happen, just a little accident or bike drops, that will be still very, very challenging in Africa. But wherever I am in the world, outside of Europe or North America, it simply is, the chances are a bit higher than with anything else if you have a Shimano group set. I also use Shimano XTR pedals and S-Fire shoes. So I go with MTB, and the reason for that is that I'm walking around quite a lot. Sometimes I have to push my bike, and it's all about comfort. So I think, in my opinion, on long distance rides, you simply want to go with MTB, not with road bike pedals and shoes. Coming to the saddle, of course, very important. I have a Brooks Campium, and I had the same actually for the Pan America. And yeah, I would be lying if I would say I never had any saddle sore, but limited. So it's a saddle that is never the most comfortable one, but it also never gets really uncomfortable. You have to get used to it. So at the beginning, the first few hundred K, it's not that nice, but for very long rides, it is really good. I have on the seat posts, handlebars, and the aero bars, it's all from Pro Bike Gear. I use a Quarrel handlebar, so I have a bit more space and I can put in my Ortley bags. So yeah, it's simply for the long distances where I have to put in some extra stuff here, it's better. And a very big change is I use spacers now on the aero bars. So that's around 8 centimeters of spacer. It's much higher. It's probably a little bit less aerodynamic, but it's a big gain in comfort. So on this time last year and the year before, I had really big issues with my neck and my back. And this time I didn't have any. And the reason, I believe, is spacers and a more comfortable seating position. So something I will always do in the future for long rides. Coming to the wheels and the tires, I use a Tune King and King Kong hub with Stanzio tubes, a Quail rim. This comes from the cross area, so it's incredibly stable and standard spokes, so I can change on my own, and I have can find supplies in most part of the world. And I had one broken spoke in Azerbaijan, otherwise zero problems, zero readjustment, so that simply works. I go with Schwalbe Pro One tires, 30 millimeters and tubeless. So it's also a big change from last year where I had tube tires, and 30 millimeters is, in my opinion, simply the best for long rides. It's fast, comfortable on the pavement, and I can also ride on gravel sections with it. So this is good. And tubeless, I had on the Pan America around 50 flats, And now I barely had any. I had a few times where like a big metal wire stick in the tire. So I lose a bit of air. I simply pull it out, turn the tire and pump it up again, and it works for the next few thousand. So once it's set up, you won't have problems for a very long time. So yeah, I will go with tubeless definitely for the future. I have lights, Sigma Nuggets in the back and Supernova Airstream in the front, and that both worked also really well. And finally, to come to the end, I use the bikepacking gear, which is of course very important because you will never ever find supplies outside of Europe and North America. I use the Ortlieb bikepacking gear. I have a saddle bag, a frame bag, and then one handle bag here. And they simply did an excellent job. Of course, you can see that they don't look new anymore, but I never had water inside and I can still use them for a few more thousand kilometers. So that was good. I also carry a dry bag and that I can put under the aero bars. So it gives me around another 7-8 liters, and I strap them around with a rope and elastic one. And then for like the long distances in Sahara or other places, I have a few more liters of gear. So yeah, that was my setup from Cape to Cape. And also for future adventures, there really isn't much I would change because we did an excellent job and survived. More coming soon about the actually gear list I had. And bye-bye.